Hello students, myself Neha Nandakumar Bendre, Assistant Professor in Zoology at Rare Shikshan Samstha's R.B. Narayan Rao Borauke College, Srirampur. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the ultrastructure of nucleus. Okay, so now we are going to learn about the ultrastructure of nuclear membrane. So students, all the eukaryotic cells that are present in or that are found in animals, plants, protista and fungi, they contain a control center, okay, where the DNA, the genetic material, is stored or it is protected in the nucleus, okay, and that protection is given by a double layered membrane, and that is called as the nuclear membrane. So today we are going to study in detail about the ultrastructure of nuclear membrane and how it is important to the nucleus. Okay, so the nuclear membrane is also called as nuclear envelope because it is giving a covering membrane to the nucleus. So it is a double walled membrane. Double means there are two layers present in that membrane. Okay, so this double walled membrane is also called as phospholipid bilayer. Okay, bilayer because it is made up of two membranes, and phospholipids are the content that are present in the membrane, and so it is called as phospholipid bilayer, which is present in the cell membranes of different kind of animals or the cells, animal cells or plant cells or any fungi or protista. Okay, so this membrane consists of the outer membrane, the inner membrane and a perinuclear space. Here I would like to show you that this is the structure of nucleus. Okay, in the previous lecture I have told you the details about the location, size, shape of different kind of nucleus. So here is the only part or structure of the nucleus where it contains the envelope, and inside the envelope there are different kind of contents present in this nucleus. So this, today we are going to concentrate or focus on the double layered membrane. So this membrane, as I have said, it consists of outer membrane, the outer covering that is facing the cytoplasm of the cell is called the outer membrane. Okay, and the inner membrane, the inner side or the inner lining of that membrane is that is facing the nucleoplasm. Okay, that is called as the inner membrane. Okay, and the space, okay, and the space present in between the outer membrane and inner membrane is called as perinuclear space, which is present in this area. Okay, so this is the region present between the outer and inner membrane is called as perinuclear space. Okay, so that contains some gelatinous fluid in between to maintain the phospholipid bilayer membrane. Okay, so as we are looking for the nuclear membrane, I have shown you in the box, we are going to study in detail the structure. So I have shown here the section, what is present in that single double walled membrane. As I have said that it contains the phospholipids, there are two layers of phospholipids. So how is the structure? And in this, one more important thing, in this nuclear membrane or the nuclear envelope, you can see the space in between each of this membrane, so that this membrane is not continuous, which is as present in the membrane of the cell. So in cell membrane there is continuous membrane, while here you can see that the nuclear membrane is discontinuous. So here we can see the differentiation between cell membrane and nuclear membrane. So this space which is present in this membrane is called as nuclear pores. So these make the membrane porous for carrying out import and export of different materials that are coming from cytoplasm or they are coming from the nucleoplasm. Okay, then next is, here you can see, as in the cell, there is a gelatinous fluid called as cytoplasm. Also, in the nucleus, inside the nuclear membrane is the nucleoplasm. Okay, that also we will study later. Okay, so now here I'm showing you about the structure of the membrane. Here you can see this is a double layered membrane, outer, inner. Here they are separated by a space called as nuclear pores. Okay, here now you see the structure, detailed structure of that double layered membrane. So as I've said that it is made up of phospholipids. Okay, so this phospholipids, how they are, so these are two layers. So these are the structure of phospholipid. The outer one is called as the, there are two types of phospholipid, that is hydrophilic and hydrophobic. Okay, so the outer one are the hydrophilic and the inner one are the hydrophobic layer. Okay, so this hydrophilic means what? These are the water loving phospholipids, and the hydrophobic means water hating. Okay, so like this there is two layers, okay, which are arranged head to tail. Okay, where the head region is turned upwards and the tail region below, and the next layer have the tail region upward and the head region below. Like this they maintain the polarity, okay, and maintain this structure. It gives integrity to that nuclear membrane structure. Okay, so this was about the phospholipid bilayer membrane. The same structure is present in the inner membrane also. Okay, the same structure by head to tail position, and the space in between is these two membranes are separated by a space called as perinuclear space. Okay, so after looking at this structure, detailed structure of the nuclear membrane, one thing I would like to tell, the size. Okay, the size here also, the size, the width of this nuclear membrane is 20 to 40 nanometer wide. Okay, to carry out different kind of rigidity, for giving the rigidity or some support to the nucleus. Okay, now let's look at the functions of the nuclear membrane. So here as you can see, the cell membrane also is present to protect the cell from any other reaction that are occurring in the different kind of environment. Okay, in the cell or in the organ. Here also the envelope is, the nuclear envelope is protecting the nucleus, where very important, as I've said previously, it's a control center which contains very important material that is called as DNA, or also it is called as, the whole structure is called as chromatin. Okay, the chromatin is present inside the nucleus, and this is a very delicate and sensitive structure that carries the genetic material, the genetic information which makes the individual. So it is very necessary to protect this DNA, and so more protection, okay, is given to the chromatin by the nuclear membrane. And whatever processes are to be carried out for the gene expression of this chromatin, okay, whatever materials are required, like RNA, tRNA, ribosomal RNA, are given to the chromatin for carrying out different kind of processes with the help of the import of the material through the nuclear pores. Also, whatever RNA ribosomes are required that are made in the nucleolus are sent into the cytoplasm for RNA processing. So that time they are exported out with the help of this nuclear pores into the cytoplasm. So nuclear membrane acts as a barrier, okay, to control the import, okay, and export of materials. Again, I repeat, it acts as a barrier to control the import and export of the material. Also, It helps in cell division. In this, how it helps, that during cell division, the first phase in the nucleus, in the cell, this phase is called as interphase, which is the preparatory phase for the mitosis. Okay, where the cell get prepared for the further cell division or further stages of mitosis. So this stage is called as where the DNA can be seen in the fine thread like structures in an entangled position and long threads. So this is the interphase phase. When it wants to move or shuffle to the next stage, that time the nuclear membrane breaks. Okay, breaking of nuclear membrane takes place so that the spindle apparatus, okay, spindle apparatus extends and joins, attaches to the chromosome, okay, and so that it can help in the further process of cell division. Okay, so in this way, for the attachment of spindle apparatus to the chromatin, the nuclear membrane breaks and therefore it helps in the cell division. Also, if you think that if the nuclear membrane wouldn't be there to protect the nucleus, if nuclear membrane is not there, then what will happen? Students, a lot of chaos is going on in the cytoplasm of the cell. Different kind of reactions are carried in the cytoplasm. Okay, different kind of cycles, metabolic cycles, where different kind of enzymes are involved. That time, different kind of acidic and basic conditions are taking place in the cytoplasm. And that time, if this enzyme or the different kind of chemical reactions act on the DNA, then what will happen? So lot of means the DNA will 100% get damaged and it will not give a proper development of the cell. The cell growth will get hampered. All the DNA reactions will get hampered. So in order to protect this genetic information, this nuclear membrane has to work properly. If there are some kind of mutations or there is no proper development of nuclear membrane, 100% the cell is going to not function properly. There will be hampering of DNA genetic information and the cell has to be dead or it will be a functionless cell. Okay, so in order to protect the control center, the DNA genetic material, nuclear membrane is very important. Okay, so now after studying about the nuclear membrane, we will see the next structure, that is called as nuclear pore. Okay, so after studying the ultrastructure of nuclear membrane, next we are going to study about the nuclear pore complex. As we have studied that in between the nuclear membrane, there is perforation of pores, or there is pore like structure for passage of transferring different kind of materials in and outside the cell, in and outside the nucleus. Okay, so now we are going to concentrate on the how is the structure of that pores. So these pores are not just a hollow space, but they are having a definite structure to carry out some important functions in the nuclear structure. Okay, so let's see that how is the nuclear pores and which the whole structure makes the complex. So here I have given you, or here I have drawn the structure, proper structure of the nuclear pore complex. So the nuclear membrane consists of several pores. Okay, so we can say that the nuclear membrane is perforated structure, okay, to carry out different functions. So each single pore is called as an annulus. Okay, here I will tell you the structure in detail. So the circular shape or that pore is called as the annulus. Okay, the number of annula can be in variable size or variable number in different kind of cells and according to the metabolic activity of the cell. If the metabolic activity or synthetic activity of the cell is more, it needs to pass or it needs to transfer different kind of materials. Okay, so accordingly the nuclear membrane is containing the annuli. Okay, this single annuli is octagonal in shape. So this structure is called as a single annuli. Okay, the annular structure, and which is showing a octagonal shape. On this, there is this collectively the first structure of this granules, this which contains the this octagonal shape contains the granules on it. Okay, so there are how many granules? There are 8 granules in each annulus. Okay, so this granules structure and the annuli and these spokes together form a nuclear pore complex. So these are collectively called as nuclear pore complex, that is called as NPC. Okay, so each annulus has the 8 granules, and these granules are present at both the nuclear and cytoplasmic surface. So I will tell you in detail in this structure. So as I've said you that each spore, so this is the structure of nuclear membrane showing outer and inner membrane. Okay, and in between this, this space which I shown in the earlier image, that space is having this structure. Okay, so what is this structure? This is the annulus. Okay, these are the annuli. So like this, the membrane can contain many pores. So in this pore, it contains the 8 granules in the octagonal, arranged in octagonal shape. And this octagonal granules or these granules are attached to this pore. So this is the central pore where there a passage of material takes place, and this pore is supported by this complex which is containing the granules. And here the spoke like structure, these are the 8 spokes, okay, given out from this granules to support the central structure at the cytoplasmic side, okay, which faces the cytoplasmic cell structure of the cell. Also same kind of structure is present, or this 8 granules are present in the nucleoplasmic side. So this is the cytoplasmic side, that is facing the cytoplasm of the cell, and this is the nucleoplasmic side. Okay, so in between this annular structure is present, which are containing the 8 granules at the upper side and 8 granules at the below side, and consisting of the spokes, okay, which is giving a cartwheel structure to this annulus. Okay, so what is happening in this, the middle structure or this here structure, there is a ring. Okay, and that middle ring is called as the iris. Just it is working just like as I do. Okay, so at the time of transport, if the nucleus is wants any kind of material from the cytoplasm, at that time only the pores will get open, just like our eyes, the pupil and the iris get open by the entrance of the light. That how much amount of the light accepts, our eyes accept. So that time the diaphragm opens and closes. In the same case, at the time of intake or export of the material, that time only these pores are open. Otherwise, these pores are not open if they are not needed by the membrane. Okay, so for that, to control that activity, okay, that only as per the requirement the pore should open, there is a presence of iris in this section. Okay, iris. Okay, so after this, so here like this different perforation of annulus takes place where any material enters through these pores and then it enters into the nucleus. So in the nucleus, this is the nucleoplasmic side. In nucleoplasm also different kind of activities takes place as the it is taking place in the cytoplasm. Okay, in the nucleoplasm also there is a semi solid gelatinous liquid present in the nucleoplasm. Okay, in this variety of different kind of enzymes, okay, it contains enzymes to carry out different kind of functions, like different kind of processes, DNA replication, okay, DNA repair, some metabolism. Also, it contains the molecules, okay, like which are granular or fibrillar in shape. These are called as interchromatic granules. Interchromatic granules, okay. So this contains different kind of small ribonuclear proteins to carry out some processing or some gene expression, that is helping the chromatin material to get activated, okay, so that gene expression may proceed, okay. Along with this, also it contains ribosomes. The chromatin material is there, so DNA, RNA is present. Along with this, the genetic material, that is DNA and RNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid, it also contain histones, proteins, okay, and non-proteins. So these are histone, two proteins called as histone, and other one is non-histone also. So these histones are found bound to the DNA, okay, to give a specific supercoiled helical structure, okay. So in histones, there are different kind of histones present in the nucleoplasm, that is H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. So different various material we can see that is present in the nucleoplasm to carry out cell growth, cell function, some processing machinery that is taking place in the nucleoplasm. So here also different, due to different kind of activity taking place in the nucleoplasm, the help is required from cytoplasm. So important materials for processing of DNA, so mRNA. So many material is coming inside the nucleoplasm with the help of this annular structure, which is called as the nuclear pore complex. So hope you have understood the ultrastructure of nuclear membrane along with this nuclear pore complex. So thank you for watching.